What's up guys, today I will show you how to get any shiny Pokemon in Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. We will do this with a sysbot created in the PokéRealms Discord. I have the allowance to create a video about this. And with that all out of the way, let's get started. So first of all, there are two methods you can use to get yourself a shiny Pokemon with the Gensect.dk bot. The Pokéhex method and the Showdown method. The Pokéhex method will give you more possibilities to customize your Pokémon, like custom OT and trainer ID. Meanwhile, the Showdown method is just a little bit easier. The downside is that you can't change OT and TID. Okay, let's start with Pokéhex. First, you will need the latest version of Pokéhex. Check the link in the description to download this file. Just click here on download. After you download the file, drag out Pokéhex. And click Options. After that you click Options, click Settings. Then you just choose Let's Go Pikachu or Eevee. A little disclaimer, you can't make shiny Mews since they aren't legal. Since you are never able to get them in Pokemon Let's Go, so don't even try getting a shiny Mew. For people that don't have any experience with Pokéhex, I recommend using this tool. You can open it by clicking Tools and then click Encounter Database. This will help you making a legit Pokemon. It's really important to know that you can't get illegal Pokemon. You can check if a Pokemon is illegal by clicking on the explanation mark. If it's legal, it will change to a check mark. If it isn't, you will see an error message explaining what is wrong. Be sure to click Auto at the bottom, so Pokéhex determines what kind of height and weight the Pokémon should have. If you use the Encounter tool, it's really easy to customize the Pokémon. Remember that in Let's Go you don't have EVs, but AVs. Every stat can have 200 AVs. When you are adding moves, be sure they have a green background at the selecting screen. That way, you know it's legal. You can also change the OT and the trainer ID. Your OT is just your name in the game. Your trainer ID is the ID a Pokémon gets when you catch it in the wild. Just look at the summary of a Pokémon and you can see your trainer ID. When you are done with making your Pokémon, click File and then Save Pokémon. Be sure you save this file as a PB7 file. When you got your PB7 file, you can go to the PokéRealms Discord and then search for the Genesect bot. I also have the bot on my Discord server, but it's their bot, so I feel like you should use their Discord. When you are in the right chat called Genesect LGPE, you type plus trade. Then you click the plus sign and click add file. Then you just add your PB7 file and send it. After that, the Genesect bot will send you a code. Go to your Let's Go, click the X button, and then click Communicate. After that, you click Play with Others. Then you click Faraway Place. And finally, you can press Link Trade. You can already type the first two Pokémon that the Genesect bot sent you. Then you just wait a little bit for the third Pokemon, until the bot says he is searching. Then just press the third Pokemon. When the bot connects, you have 15 seconds to offer your own Pokemon. Then just trade, it's quite easy. As you can see, I used a Parasect file for competitive. The Genesect bot also sent you a BB7 file. It contains the info for the Pokemon you just sent him. You could use it to check your secret ID if you traded the Pokemon away that you got yourself. Let's start with the Pokemon Showdown method. I will also put a link in the description so you can find the site really easy. You don't have to make an account, you can skip that step. First thing you have to do is go to the team builder. Make a new team. After that, you can see a button to change the format. Check in the list with the name USUM Singles, Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon Singles. The bottom option in that list is called Let's Go OU. Click that option. Now you can create your Pokemon. Choose whatever Pokemon you want, beside the shiny Mew of course, since it's illegal. You can decide what kind of moves it has to learn and what item it holds. When you click in the box details, you can make it shiny. When you click the button Import/Export, you have to make sure to change the ability to a legal ability. If you don't know what ability the Pokemon can have, you can make a second Pokemon and look at the abilities. After you have done that, you can copy the Import/Export text by selecting the text and then use your right mouse button and then click Copy. Or select the text and press Ctrl+C. Then go to the Genesect bot in Discord. Type plus trade and then right click and press paste. Or press Ctrl+V. Then press enter. You get a DM from the Genesect bot with the code. Go to your Pokemon Let's Go, click the X button. Click communicate. Then you click play with others. After that, be sure to click Faraway Place, and then finally press Link Trade. You can type the first two Pokemon the bot sent at you. Just wait a little bit for the third Pokemon, until the bot says he is searching. Then press the third Pokemon. When the Pokemon connects to you, you have 15 seconds to offer your own Pokemon. Then just trade. And just like that, you got yourself a shiny Pokemon. I will also make a template in the description, so you can use that to make your own Pokemon. I want to thank 6A, Santa, Bewares, and Bones for making this bot. This is the first ever Pokemon Let's Go Sis bot. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comment section, or join my Discord and ask it there. I read every comment on my channel. Comments are the best way to give me that little boost to keep making these kind of videos. Be sure to leave a like, maybe subscribe, and you could check out my channel and look at my other Pokemon tutorials. Good luck with making your shiny Pokemon. See ya!